Don't let doubt stand in your way.
Good evening. My name is Dan Wathke, for those of you I don't know, and I'm one of the pastors here at Belmont Church. I have the honor to be part of tonight's service. Welcome to those who are online streaming, especially Barbara and Diane, his sisters. It's good to have you guys with us tonight, and friends, and throughout the country, and possibly even the world. Welcome. So tonight, we're going to open with some worship. Terry was a man of music, and he was a man of the Lord, so it seems fitting to open with some worship songs. Alan Terry is leading us tonight. We're going to look at one of Terry's music videos. He had many songs. One of them, particular, Help Is On The Way. We're going to have that video. Then there will be an open time for sharing. We've got some people in the room that will share. We've got some videos. And then if there's anybody here that would also just like to share a story or a memory, we'll have that available as well. We have a devotional thought followed by one more of Terry's songs. And then after the close, we invite you to stay, hang out. We've got snacks and refreshments out there, so just you're welcome to stay in fellowship. Let me open us in prayer and then just invite you, if you would, stand, and we will worship together. Father, I thank you. Thank you for each person here. I thank you, Father, for each person joining us online. I thank you, Father, for each person who will see this. Lord, I pray that we would honor Terry tonight, Lord, that, Father, you would stir in us, Lord. We thank you for him. We thank you for the life that he represented, Lord, that he lived, Father, that he carried your spirit, that he shone your light brightly. And now, Lord, we just come before you just to worship you, Lord, because you are the creator. And we thank you for this brother, and we thank you for this time together. In Jesus' name, amen.
Hallelujah. 10,000 years and then 4. Yeah. and Holy Ghost. Amen.
You can be seated. Thank you.
Troubles have got you down. I've been there too. Things have a way of working out. All depends on you. Somewhere in your hope seems so far away. Don't let doubt stand in your way.
Okay, yeah, let's get that mic on here. Good evening, everybody. Thank you so much for showing up tonight and being here. I know Terry would be very, very proud that you're here. And do I need to hold it or just?
Yeah, it'd be better if you did.
I will.
Thank you.
Thank you. So I'm going to read Terry's obituary as given to me by his sister, Diane. Let me just read that, and then I'm going to share a little bit. Terry Roger Bell, 71, died Friday, February the 16th, 2024, at a live hospice in Nashville, Tennessee. Terry was born April 20th, 1952, in Port Huaymain, California, to Gerald Bell and Louise Bell. Sorry, I should have brought some cheaters. No, I'll be good. I'll just bring it a little closer. Terry grew up in Grand Forks, North Dakota. He graduated from Grand Forks Central High School in 1970. He left Grand Forks the day that he graduated from high school to pursue a career in music. Terry was a talented songwriter, guitarist, and performer. He was in many bands over the years. He lived and shared his music and positive attitude in California, New York, Oregon, and Colorado. He made many lifelong friends wherever he lived. And I can attest to that. Terry moved to Nashville in 1988. He worked as a performer and as an extra in films and videos. He also worked at Gibson Guitars, fixing guitars there. I didn't know that. Terry had a successful career as a songwriter. He worked for many years at Gateway Entertainment, collaborating on many hit songs. Terry loved Jesus, his family, and his many friends and fellow musicians. His kindness and positive attitude will be missed. Amen to that. Terry struggled with health problems due to long COVID since the 2020 bout that he had. His faith in Jesus sustained him through that struggle, and he remained encouraged and uplifting to all who knew him. So true. He is survived by his sisters, Diane and Barbara, and his nephew, Jason, and niece, Amy, and five great nephews and nieces. He was preceded in death by his parents, grandparents, and many other relatives. I just want to share a little bit about Terry I learned many things. I've been tasked by Terry several years ago that when he passed that I would go through his belongings and clear out his apartment. So I've been going through lots of pictures and lots of photo albums and that kind of thing. And there's a lot about Terry I didn't know. And I thought we were fairly close. We were buddies, and he was one of my inner circle friends, someone I could talk to at any time and pray with, and just a good, good, solid Christian man. But Terry was very successful in music, much more than I realized, and he was very talented, as you can tell by the song that we played and have been playing. But Terry had other talents as well. He was an entrepreneur. He started a business where he sold very nice computer bags, and he had that business going, and I still have one of his bags here with me today. And Terry won a contest in Colorado back probably in the 80s, where he came in first place as a musician there for, I guess, the Colorado area for a country music competition. And then I guess he went on to the next level, wherever that was. So Terry was an amazing man. But the thing that I would share with anybody about Terry was that he was a very kind man, a very gentle man. And, I don't ever remember seeing Terry mad. Never. Never saw him angry. That doesn't mean that he never got angry, but I never saw him that way. And so he was very even-keeled in his personality and always had an encouraging word. And I know through these times of COVID and whatnot that it was difficult for him to be in the hospital and in rehab because it was just hard, And I had moved away and was able to call on occasion. But, he told me sometimes, he said, I would just like to see Jesus with skin on, And what that tells me is, and this is a lesson that I've learned through this whole thing, is that if you have a friend or a relative that's in the hospital, go see them. Go see them often. Tell them to crank up their computer and have some Zoom calls with them. And I think TJ so much for the Zoom calls that she coordinated with Terry and her friends. Terry was in a group called the COVID Long Haulers because they had issues with COVID long after the initial bout. And so that's really what caused Terry's death, as he had AFib, and that led to some other issues and probably a stroke, I'm guessing. But he was a trooper. I tell you what, he was very persevering, and he went through a lot of difficult times, difficult, dark times of the soul, if you will, through this whole ordeal. But Terry's with the Lord now. He was a very strong Christian, and his faith showed in everything he did. And he would share the faith with others. And so we know where he is, and if you're a believer in the Lord Jesus Christ, you're going to be with him one day, and that's our hope, isn't it? All right, and we're going to open it up, see somebody else shares next. Is that correct? Anybody that would like to get up and share a word about Terry, please come up.
Hi, I'm Stephen Cole, and I became a friend of Terry, Sir Andrew. He gave him his old Jeep that he had gotten years ago, and I had worked on it a few times for him probably about 12, 13 years ago, and in preceding years I had worked with Terry and helped him keep him in wheels, so it was not always easy, but I had to tell him I couldn't fix it anymore last summer, which I felt bad about because it just was too far gone for me to repair. It was beyond my ability, but I'll tell you, getting to know him and getting to know his music was amazing, and his humility, his humbleness, and his perseverance, and his, not just the COVID, but just the way he always looked into that. Also, he was managing someone else's music collection for somebody else, and he was starting to do pretty successful with that, he said. And I hope that, so I don't know who's going to be able to pick that up from him, but hopefully somebody does, and his own music. Hope that that has a life still. But he just had the ability to never lose heart when I was dealing with bad news about his car, stuff like that. He never got mad. He was just always very even-keeled and very graceful and peaceful, and I think that's what any of us who are in a Christian mindset want to emulate, and I thank you for letting me say a few words. Is there anybody else?
Good to see you, by the way. Hey there. Hi, I'm Jim Jackson, and you referenced the support group that Terry was in after he was in the ICU with COVID, and so I'm the doctor that leads that support group. And Terry called me after he got out of the ICU and then sent me an email, and we talked, and he joined the support group, and he was a regular member of that support group for many, many weeks, dozens of times. We saw him in that support group really until near the end when he got quite ill. And I look back this past week, I was hugely saddened by his passing, as you all were, but I look back at the emails that we had exchanged, and after the first support group, he had sent an email, and he said, I really think my music and my presence can help encourage people in the group to be hopeful and to be positive and to be forward-looking, all of the things that I came to know as unique features of Terry's. And he would talk a lot about his music. Occasionally, I'd have to say, it's time to move on to the next person, Terry. And we'd do that. But he'd talk about his music, and he'd talk about his faith. Faith, obviously, he and I share. And it developed that way that he approached things in the group developed, I think, a deep attachment and a deep affection that was very much. Two ways, right? Not only Terry toward other people, but other people toward Terry. They developed a deep attachment and really a love for Terry, because I think to know Terry really was to love Terry. And I was really saddened, and everyone in the support group was, as we learned that his health was failing. As you know, he was in the ICU with COVID, and he recovered, but not quite. You know, he had significant problems with malnutrition that continued. He couldn't gain any weight. He had a lot of the classic features of something we call post-intensive care syndrome. And then when he got ill again, he really didn't have the physical buffers in place, if you will, to fight things off. And at the end of the day, of course, he passed. But he leaves a really big hole in the support group. We talked about him yesterday. We're going to dedicate a specific group to really honoring him. And I think he'll be alive in years and decades to come in the hearts of people in the support group who will honor him, I think, by trying to be a little bit more like him. And to me, to be a little bit more like him is to be kinder, to be more loving, to be gentler, to aspire to help other people with full sincerity. Those are the things that I've taken from him. And he was a gift to me and a gift to the 20 or so odd people in the support group who were really people from all over the world who got to know Terry. So we'll miss him. I know I'll see him again playing Help Is On the Way or Find the Stars or whatever that is. And there's a lot of comfort in that. So it's lovely to be here to reflect on Terry tonight. Thank you.
Thank you.
I hate to hog the conversation, but I did want to share something about Terry. You know, Terry was from North Dakota, and I'm from East Tennessee. You know, I'm a country boy from East Tennessee. So you might imagine, what's the connection there? I mean, so different in our culture and whatever. But Terry and I grew up kind of in the same era, the same music. I looked at some of his musical influences, and they were many of my same influences. And so, but the main thing was that we were both believers, you know, and we used to go to the singles group here at Belmont, and that's how we got to know one another. And Terry loved to get together and watch movies. So we would have movie nights, and it would be like three or four guys, and then it would be down to just Terry and I. So Terry and I were able to build a good bond that way. And we watched some really cool movies together and shared life together. And but that bond that we had as believers is what really cemented us together, because there's just something about that. You can build a bond with anybody around the world, regardless of their ethnic makeup or socioeconomic whatever. If you have Jesus, there's that common bond that you can share with one another, and it makes you friends, makes you part of the same family. Amen.
Remember me. Don't remember me with sadness. Don't remember me with tears. Remember all the laughter we shared through the years. Now I'm contented that my life was worthwhile, knowing as I passed along the way, I made somebody smile. When you are walking down the street and you've got me on your mind, I'm walking in your footsteps, only half a step behind. So please don't be unhappy just because I'm out of sight. Remember that I'm with you each morning and each night. Reading that poem, when I was looked over it, it really made me think of Terry. Terry was always full of sunshine, always the positivity, never negative, always smiling, just like his song said, you know, help is on the way. And Terry walked in Jesus's footsteps every day. So just seeing this poem really touched my heart and made me think of Terry Bell. Terry, I'll always listen to your music from now on. In fact, I've been listening to some of them almost nonstop. But you were an amazing, amazing man. The night in the hospital before you went to hospice, one of the girls, Becca, was singing to you, and you had been unresponsive the entire time. And then all of a sudden you woke up and you gave us a thumbs up and you were smiling and moving your arms. It was absolutely amazing. We could feel the love with you, Terry. We wanted you to know how much we loved you, and we wanted to be there for you. I love you, Terry.
Hi, I'm Becca Gant. I'm a friend of Terry's. I met Terry a few years ago in our COVID long hauler support group at Vanderbilt. We also shared the love of God and the love of music. The way Terry lived his life made me want to be a better person. He inspired me so much. He was always smiling and happy, even in the midst of difficult circumstances and this illness that he was fighting. And every time we talked, he would say how good God is. And I admired that so much about him. He was also an amazing singer-songwriter. His songs were unbelievable and so meaningful. He was such a great talent and had so many gifts. He was still pursuing his music, still writing songs, and wanting to touch others through his music. In an interview that Terry did in January of 2023, he said, "I hope that when people listen to my songs, they find hope and encouragement not to give up when times get tough and to keep on living, dreaming, and believing that things will get better." That was so Terry. In another interview, Terry encouraged others to never give up on your dreams, and he was such an example of that. I'm so grateful that before Terry went to heaven, I was able to tell him how loved he was by so many people, especially those in our COVID long hauler support group, and how much he meant to me, and how he inspired me to do three things differently in my life: to be more positive and optimistic like he was, to talk more about God and my faith like Terry did, and to keep doing music no matter what I'm going through. Knowing Terry these past few years has changed my life for the better, and I'm forever grateful. As we remember him and what an amazing man he was and how he lived his life the way God intended us to, let's keep his music alive by listening to his songs, sharing his songs with others, and let's aspire to be more like him. And I pray for his sisters and his friends that God would give you comfort and peace that passes all understanding. This last week, I was able to tell Terry that when he got to heaven to be with Jesus, I knew that God was going to say to him, "Well done, good and faithful servant." God bless you.
Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever.
I'm going to try to get through this. I don't like speaking in front of people. So on Saturday, I put a picture up on Terry on Instagram and tagged him. And then I saw that Terry liked it, and I was like, if anybody was going to reach through the metaverse, it would be Terry, you know? And I was like, whoa. But then I was like, okay. Wait a minute, this is, so I asked, you know, who is this? Like, Terry passed. And it's his friend, Thomas Hibner, and he runs Terry's account. He's in Illinois, and he's watching. Hi, Thomas. And he wanted me to read this for him. said he wanted to keep it simple. And Terry, the beginning was when you answered the phone while you were working with Ron Cornelis as I pitched a song to you when I was 17 years old. I'm grateful for that day. And over the years, we have become close. You have become a mentor, co-writer, and a great friend. I enjoyed the times we shared to bring our vision to life. Memories of you will never fly away from my heart. And I think what we've been hearing repeatedly from everyone tonight, I mean, even with the messages, and it's just how much Terry was a positive influence in all our lives and how sweet he was. He was such a sweet man. I go through bouts of really deep depression and I kind of go radio silent. And I would constantly get emails from Terry or text messages, sending his songs and telling me that I had a bright spirit or fear. I can't remember the words, but they were really positive. And when you self-loathe yourself to have someone tell you these things from someone like him, really meant a lot. And I started this trip. I live in Alaska, as Dr. Jackson knows. I started this trip. I flew on Thanksgiving because my dad was dying. And because of circumstances, I wasn't allowed to be with him when he passed away. I had prepared myself, read up, like what I do is I over-research everything so I could be, you know, not freaked out and be a calming presence for him while he transitioned. And I felt really lost in the past couple of months since that happened. Really lost. And I talk with Terry quite a bit, and you know, I was trying to help him with the nursing home. And one thing I'll say, he'll be really happy he doesn't have to eat that nursing food anymore. Really happy. But even in the midst of that, like, he was going through some struggles, but it wasn't like all doom and gloom with him. Even when it was bad, he had a way of making it not so bad. And so I talked to him on Friday, and then on Saturday his phone just went to voicemail. And me and Barbara and Becca, we were trying to figure out what happened to him, because we were like, he would let us know if he went home. And then on Monday, or was it Tuesday, things have been a little bit, I'm not the best with time, but we found out, because when I called on Monday at the nursing home, all they could say was he wasn't there anymore, and they couldn't give me any more information. And then we found out he was at TriStar Hospital, and I left Wednesday and drove from Memphis straight to the hospital, and I signed up for a free Zoom Pro, and we just started keeping vigil with him. And I promised him that night, because he had told the nurse at Belmont, and that nurse had told the nurse at TriStar. And if Colette is watching, Colette, thank you for being an amazing nurse and really wonderful human being. And he said he didn't want to die alone. And so I promised him that night he would not die alone. And then we went back on Thursday. I went to the wrong hospital. I didn't realize there were different TriStars, but finally got to the right one. And Jenna, who works with Dr. Jackson, who's a wonderful human being, she was there, and we set up the Zoom. And Becca, who you just heard singing, started singing, and Terry opened his eyes. And he gave us a thumbs up, and he smiled so big, and it was just, for 3.5 hours, he was with us, and I can't tell you how much Terry gave me in that moment. And then we stayed with him until hospice came at 8 that night, and his oxygen was at 100%, so I felt like he was fine to go home, and I got some sleep, and then I went to Alive Hospice. Everyone at Alive Hospice was incredible, and his sister finally got to get on the Zoom, and we gave them privacy, and as soon as Terry got done having that time with his sister, he started progressing. And I was like, this man had such a strong heart that he held on for a week to be able to tell his sister goodbye. And I felt a lot of things. But then after that phone call, around like 8 p.m., I had Becca and Alicia and Barbara. I was like, look, his face just, he turned into a young man. He didn't have one wrinkle on his face, and his skin was glowing. Like, I've used a lot of products, and my skin has never glowed like that. It was, I don't have the words for it. And he just looked so at peace. And when he finally left, some other stuff happened that I don't have words for, but it was the most beautiful. He was happy. There was no sadness. And he left me with a peace that I wouldn't have right now, and a gift. And for that, I'm eternally grateful to him. And I really suck at this, but yeah. I did have one last thing to read, sorry. My nerves are shot. We played Terry a lot of gospel hymns, and I wanted to read this one. Oh, well, I'm tired and so weary, but I must go alone till the Lord comes and calls me away, oh, yes. Well, the morning's so bright, and the lamp is a light, and the night is black as the sea, oh, yes. There will be peace in the valley for me someday. There will be peace in the valley for me, O Lord, I pray. There will be no sadness, nor sorrow, nor trouble I see. There will be peace in the valley for me. Well, the bear will be gentle, and the wolves will be tame, and the lion shall lay down by the lamb, oh yes. And the beasts from the wild shall be lit by a child, and I will be changed from this creature that I am, oh yes. There will be peace in the valley for me someday. There will be peace in the valley for me, oh Lord, I pray. There will be no sadness, no sorrow. Oh my Lord, no trouble I see. There will be peace in the valley for me. And Terry showed me that peace.
You asked for a song to be played, so we're going to play a song.
As I went down in the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the starry crown, good Lord, show me the way. Oh, sisters, let's go down, let's go down, come on down. Oh, sisters, let's go down in the river to pray. As I went down in the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the robe and crown, good Lord, show me. Oh, brothers, let's go down, come on down. Come on, brothers, let's go down in the river to pray. As I went down in the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the starry crown, the Lord, show me. Oh, fathers, let's go down. Let's
studying about that good old way. And who shall wear the robe and crown? Good Lord, show me the way.
So I've known Terry for a little over 20 years through Belmont Church. We had a songwriters guild here, and he'd come share songs. And at one point, he just lived a few blocks down the road. So we'd run into each other in the neighborhood. I got to know him pretty well. And I appreciate each of you sharing. Thank you. Thank you. The common theme is an encourager. He's optimistic. He's positive. I've sometimes heard that he's obviously a man of faith. I've sometimes heard people reference that faith as his religion. But really, I would dare to use a different R word to describe his faith, and that would be his relationship. His relationship with Jesus. That was at the forefront of all he did. His conversations pointed to God. His songs pointed to God. His demeanor pointed to God. And it's interesting because, you know, obviously Terry was pre-wired with this positivity. But at some point, that's not sustainable in our own ability. And so he realized he had a revelation at some point that he needed a savior to sustain that in him. A revelation, you know, the boil down the Christian faith to God sent his only begotten son, that whosoever believed in him would not perish, believed in him would not perish, but have everlasting life. And that's what Terry is experiencing right now, this everlasting life. And we miss him. There's a void, certainly, on this side of heaven. But Thessalonians tells us that as believers, we do not grieve like those without hope, because we know that reuniting will happen again with him. I spoke with a gentleman today, Gene Schmidt, and Gene is a music producer. He called me yesterday and left me a message. I'd never talked to Gene before today. And he said he's producing a record for Kings Hill House of Prayer. It's called Sounds of Revival. And the song, he has a song Terry's going to have on the record called Father's Love. And he described Terry very similar to what you've heard here, humble. Humble demeanor, sensitive to what the Lord wanted. And Terry wanted his music to make a difference. He wasn't out to build his name. He wanted music that would impact people, that would point people to God. So in honor of Terry and in his walk, I felt compelled to ask, how is your relationship with Jesus? Have you grown dormant? Do you know him? I'm going to play a slideshow here in a minute with a Terry Bell original song called Find the Stars. And in just listening to the song and Googling Terry Bell, there's all kinds of interesting things. But I found an article, and this is what Terry said about this song. He said, I'm a big fan of the TV series Touched by an Angel. You guys remember Touched by an Angel? I watched that pretty. I actually recorded a bunch of them on VHS back in the day. And he said, I was watching an old rerun one night, and there was a conversation between the two angels, Tess and Monica. And Monica was asking Tess what people do when they are walking through darkness. And Tess said they find the stars. When I heard that, I thought, wow, what a great idea. It inspired me so much, I started thinking about writing a song and about finding the stars. And the song was released in September 2020. He says, I got COVID-19 and pneumonia right after Christmas, and I ended up very sick in the ICU. The meaning of that song became much more personal to me when I started thinking about all of my friends calling to check on me and tell me they were praying for me and loved me and cared about me. It helped me to realize that I was not alone. Even though I felt that sometimes, especially when I was feeling fearful, weak, and my faith wasn't strong, I believe that God was with me and that he sent nurses and doctors and friends to give me the words of hope and encouragement that I needed to hear to keep me going. To me, the song is not about finding the stars in the sky, but looking for the stars in our lives. Our friends and family and children and loved ones who are there to brighten our lives, especially in the dark and difficult times we go through in life. They shine bright like the stars in the sky. And so I go to the Word, the Bible. Well, what does the Lord say about shining brightly? In Matthew 5:16 says, "Let your light shine before men in such a way that they may see your good works and glorify your Father in heaven." And who is that light? John 8:12 tells us, Jesus says, "I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life." And that was Terry. His light shines brightly to the glory of God. May we do the same. Let me pray. Father, I thank you. I thank you that Terry did have revelation of you, Jesus. And I thank you that not only did he have revelation, but he was intentional about walking it, and he was intentional about pursuing relationship with you, Jesus. And I ask, Lord, as we reflect tonight, and as even after we leave, Father, we don't want to grow dormant. I ask that nobody within the sound of my voice, would grow dormant in their relationship with you. Father, I pray for even those who know you, there'd be new revelation of who you are and what you have for each of us in our life. So, Lord, I love you. I thank you for Terry, Lord. I thank you for a life well lived, a life that shone brightly for your glory. And I pray this in Jesus' name. Let's watch this video. Stars. Find the stars. Let me encourage you to hang out. It's like family. If you want to partake, please do with our refreshments out there and hang out as long as you'd like. Hope you guys are stirred and inspired. And never want to miss an opportunity if anybody would like prayer. I know that walking through these things can also, there's a lot of hurt, there's a lot of pain, there's voids. So feel free, I'm available to pray. Andrew's available to pray. We'd be glad to pray with you. Online community, my number's on the website. Feel free to give me a call. Thank you guys for coming and honoring a wife, a life well lived. Bless you guys. She's got a heart like